thank you very much. And to make a long story short, not longer than 2 hours, I would like to mention only three things. First, I'm really very glad to be here. I think it's one of the best places in the world, but it's an honor for me to be here. And these words are not just politeness. Those of you who know me know that I'm not polite at all. It's not a politeness, it's a truth. Because, you know, I think that people like you make a future. They really make a future. And you make a job which will make a life of billions of people much better. They will live longer, they will be more healthy, they will be more independent from the environment, their kids will be more clever and better educated. And all this will happen because of your job. And you know, I'm a psychologist in my background, so it's easy for me to quotate psychologists and quotate businessmen or scientists or other scientists and so on. It was one prominent American psychologist, Abraham Maslow, the father and the founder of so-called humanistic psychology, and he said that really mentally healthy people, they do not make a difference between the job and between job and play. Their job is a fun for them. They enjoy their job. And I think that you are so risky, so active, so creative, because you like what you do. And it's because you like what you do, the humanity has the benefits of your job. So it's really an honor for me to be here. And several words about Rosnana. Rosnana is a Russian structure, and it's state-backed $10 billion fund. And we invest in different spheres. We invest in life science, in energy, in many, many other things, but forget about it, because we are not the largest fund in the world. We are the largest in Russia, we are not the largest in the world. Another news about Russia is that we support Russian-American cooperation. More than 20% of our investments here. We invested about $1.5 billion in 21 American structures, and we are planning to prolong this politic. But you can forget about this as well, because there are countries and structures who invest more in America. But there is a third piece of information which is really important. It's our goal. Our goal. We are not just a fund. Our goal to create nanotechnological industry in Russia. Many people say that this mission is impossible. Because, you know, for centuries, Russia was defeated in such technological competition. We always bought everything people do by their hands and by their brains. We always sell oil, gas, wood, and so on and so on. So we must create our company, must create an industry which never existed in Russia, never. And many people think that it's impossible. But you know, Rosnana, led by these very people and this very person who always resolved the tasks which everybody says unresolvable at all. This very person, Anatoly Chubais, the leader of Rosnana, made private property in Russia after 70 years of communism. He created financial stabilization in Russia. He made a lot of other absolutely impossible things. So when our friends and colleagues and our opponents say that this mission impossible, we say, okay, let's try. And I think we'll be successful. And the last point about Russia, we are a Russian company. You have two types of news about Russia now. You have bad news, a lot of bad news. It's number one, type number one. And type number two, you have very bad news about Russia. And I do not want to discuss it. Some of this information is true, sometimes it's not true, but okay, forget about it. I would like to mention here three good news about Russia, which are important for those who are thinking about cooperation with Russia. Either they're Russian-speaking colleagues or non-Russian-speaking colleagues, it doesn't matter. The good news number one, we are huge market for high tech. After 70 years of communism, after 70 years of staying in lines, after 70 years of deficit for everything, our people want to buy. They want to buy cars and medicine, computers and telephones. They want to buy. And I think it's one of the largest market in the world. It's number one. Number two, there are a lot of people in Russia who are well educated, who are very professional, who are hardworking, and whose mentality is very close to your mentality, guys. You know, I'm traveling all around the country. And somewhere in Russian province, in the poor cities, when you are in Technopark or something like this, you feel yourself in Silicon Valley. Because the guys who are working there, and their type of communication, and their system of values, exactly like here in Silicon Valley, so these guys are your natural partners. And number three, and it's a good news also, I think. You know, we have a lot of disagreements inside the country. We have a lot of turbulence inside the country. But everybody in Russia, everybody, and everybody among Russian elites understand that we have no other way. We must create innovation economy. If we do not do it, if we defeat it, if we failed, Russia will disappear as a country, as a civilization, as a culture, and everybody understands it. So, any government in Russia, any government, you can like it or you can dislike it, as me, of course, but any government in Russia will do its best to create innovation economy. But it's impossible to create innovation economy without cooperation with the world leaders, without cooperation with the Silicon Valley. And I think it's good news for everybody who wants to cooperate with Russia. And let me say that again, that I'm very glad to be here, and good luck in your business, and in your good luck in, how to say in English, you have such words here in the restaurants. In Russian, it sounds a little bit strange. Enjoy your food. In Russian, it's a little bit strange. So let me say, enjoy your business. Thank you.